Welcome back to our YouTube channel. If you are new here, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to stay updated with our latest content. We're diving deep into the methods hackers use, the tech behind these hacks. Now we're all about ethical hacking here. Think of this video as your digital self-defense course. Understanding how these vulnerabilities work is the first step to making sure your conversations and information stay private. We'll be covering everything from WhatsApp web to SS7 vulnerabilities, phishing scams, and even those sketchy WhatsApp clones. So buckle up, hit that subscribe button, and let's get started. All right, let's kick things off with something most of us use all the time, WhatsApp web. It's super convenient, right? Being able to message from your computer without picking up your phone is awesome, but this convenience can actually open you up to some security risks. Here's the deal. WhatsApp web works by basically mirroring your phone's WhatsApp account on your computer. It does this through a QR code that you scan with your phone. Now, that's all fine and good if you're the only one scanning that code, but imagine you're at a public place, maybe a coffee shop, and you leave your computer unattended for a bit. Someone could easily walk by, scan a QR code from their phone, and boom, they have access to your entire WhatsApp account on their computer. They can see your messages, your contacts, even send messages as you. It's pretty scary stuff, and it's a lot easier than you might think. So, how do you protect yourself? Well, first off, be mindful of where you're using WhatsApp web. Avoid public computers, and if you're using a shared computer, make sure to log out every single time. And here's a pro tip: enable two-factor authentication on your WhatsApp account. This adds an extra layer of security by requiring a PIN code in addition to your password when logging in on new devices. We'll talk more about two-factor authentication later, but for now, just know that it's your best friend when it comes to online security. All right, let's move on to the next vulnerability. Next up, we're getting a bit more technical with MAC address spoofing. Now, a MAC address is like a unique identifier for your device's network card. It's how your device is identified on a network. Hackers can use something called a packet analyzer, a program that captures network traffic to figure out your phone's MAC address if they're on the same Wi-Fi network as you. Once they have your MAC address, they can use a technique called MAC address spoofing to disguise their own device as yours. Basically, they're creating a digital clone of your phone on the network. And because WhatsApp uses your MAC address as part of its security protocol, the hacker's device can trick WhatsApp into thinking it's actually you. This gives them access to your account, just like with WhatsApp web. So how do you prevent this? Well, avoiding public Wi-Fi is always a good idea, especially networks that aren't password protected. Those are like open invitations for hackers. You can also use a VPN, which stands for Virtual Private Network. A VPN encrypts your internet traffic and routes it through a secure server, making it much harder for hackers to intercept your data, even on public Wi-Fi. There are a ton of great VPN options out there, both free and paid, so I'll leave some links in the description for you to check out. But for now, just know that MAC address spoofing is a real threat, and using a VPN is one of the best ways to protect yourself. All right, let's get even deeper into the technical weeds with SS7 vulnerabilities. Now, SS7 stands for Signaling System No 7, and it's basically the backbone of the global telecommunications network. It's how your phone calls, text messages, and yes, even your WhatsApp messages are routed around the world. Sounds pretty important, right? Well, it is. But here's the thing, the SS7 protocol is old, like really old. It was developed back in the 1970s, long before cybersecurity was even a thing. And because of its age, SS7 has some serious security flaws that hackers can exploit. One way hackers can exploit SS7 is to intercept your text messages, including those two-factor authentication codes that WhatsApp and other services use. Remember how I said two-factor authentication is your best friend? Well, SS7 attacks can sometimes bypass even this extra layer of security. Another way hackers can use SS7 is to track your location. They can literally pinpoint your location in real time just by knowing your phone number. It's pretty freaky stuff. So what can you do about it? Unfortunately, there's not a whole lot you can do on your end to prevent SS7 attacks. It's more of a problem with the telecom companies and how they secure their networks, but being aware of the issue is the first step. Keep an eye out for any suspicious activity on your account, like messages you didn't send or calls you didn't make. And if you're really concerned, you can contact your mobile carrier and ask them about their SS7 security measures. Chapter 4. Phishing. Don't get hooked by these scams. Okay, let's shift gears a bit and talk about phishing. Now, phishing is a social engineering attack where hackers try to trick you into giving them your personal information, like your WhatsApp login credentials. They might send you an email or a text message that looks like it's from WhatsApp or another trusted source, like your bank. These messages are often very well designed and look incredibly official. They might say something like, "Your WhatsApp account has been compromised. Click here to reset your password." Or, "You've received a message from WhatsApp. Click here to view it." But here's the thing. Those links, they're not going to WhatsApp. They're going to a fake website that the hacker has set up to steal your information. So, how do you avoid getting phished? First and foremost, be wary of any unsolicited messages that ask for your personal information. WhatsApp will never ask for your password or other sensitive information via email or text message. Pay close attention to the sender's email address or phone number. Does it actually match the official WhatsApp address or number? If not, it's probably a phishing attempt. And never ever click on links in suspicious emails or text messages. If you're not sure, go directly to the official website or app to log in or check your account. Remember, when it comes to phishing, your best defense is a healthy dose of skepticism. Chapter 5. Keyloggers, the silent keystroke thieves. All right, now let's talk about keyloggers. Keyloggers are a type of malware, that's malicious software, that can record every single keystroke you make on your device. That includes your passwords, your messages, your credit card numbers, everything. Hackers can install keyloggers on your device in a few different ways. They might trick you into downloading a malicious app that's disguised as something legitimate, or they could use a phishing attack to get you to install a keylogger without even realizing it. Once the keylogger is on your device, it runs silently in the background, recording everything you type and sending that information back to the hacker. You might not even know it's there. So, how do you protect yourself from keyloggers? First off, be very careful about the apps you download. Stick to official app stores like the Google Play Store or Apple's App Store, and read the reviews before you install anything. Keep your device's operating system and apps up to date. Software updates often include security patches that can fix vulnerabilities that keyloggers exploit, and consider using a reputable antivirus or anti-malware app. These apps can scan your device for keyloggers and other threats and remove them before they can do any damage. Chapter 6. WhatsApp clones. Beware of imposter apps. Finally, let's talk about WhatsApp clones. These are fake versions of WhatsApp that are designed to look and feel like the real thing, but they're actually loaded with malware. Hackers often spread these clones through third-party app stores or websites that promise things like free WhatsApp or WhatsApp with extra features. But here's the catch. Once you install one of these clones, you're basically giving hackers full access to your device and all your data. They can steal your WhatsApp account, your contacts, your messages, everything. So how do you avoid these clones? It's simple. Only download WhatsApp from the official Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Don't be tempted by apps that promise free stuff or extra features. They're almost always too good to be true. And if you see an app that looks suspiciously like WhatsApp, but has a different name or developer, steer clear. It's better to be safe than sorry. Remember, when it comes to your security, stick to the official sources and you'll be good to go. That's a wrap for today. We've covered a lot of ground, from WhatsApp web and MAC address spoofing to SS7 vulnerabilities, phishing, keyloggers, and even those sneaky WhatsApp clones. Remember, the best way to protect yourself from these threats is to stay informed and be proactive about your cybersecurity. enable two-factor authentication, use strong passwords, be wary of suspicious messages and links, and keep your devices and apps up to date. If you found this video helpful, hit that thumbs up button and share it with your friends and family to help them stay safe online. And don't forget to subscribe for more tech deep dives and cybersecurity tips. Until next time.